day to day. Wake and pray, make that play. Get some good at my place. There's some on the way, cause my bro's on the way. I got stones on my gold, I got loads in my safe. Had a 7-figure summer, so I'm putting on some weight. Set up getting thick, so I put it on display.
What is wrong here? I make a joke, everybody laughs.
Yeah, I just ran a checkup on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself. I'm so icy, got that GG on my belt. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no L's. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. And I'm fine as hell from my head down to my nails. My man tripping cause I got another cell. He still buy me YSL. I could get it by myself. I could get it by myself. I could get it by myself. These, I could get it by myself. I'ma get it by myself, yeah.
Hey everybody, it's the coach. This is a special edition of the Divisional Round Playoffs on EA Sports. Straight ahead, we've got a great one on tap between the Seattle Seahawks and the Carolina Panthers. With that, let's get up to Charlotte. Standing by, our broadcast team, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Coach, it is something not seen all that often in these parts. Playoff football in North Carolina. We've got it at Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Coming up, an important divisional round matchup in the NFC between the Seattle Seahawks and the Carolina Panthers. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
McCaffrey, 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave him with a third and about four more for a first. Here's Sean. He's going to go for a big play downfield. And that's caught inside the 30. And they finally do get him, but not before he reaches the 27.
All right, Charles, let me put you in the head of one of those defenders out there. You have a big play like that go against you so early. What does that shake your confidence?
It shouldn't, but it often does, because your thought process all during the week is how you're going to get after that offense and make your plays. And when they make one against you, it makes you a little bit hesitant.
Time to regroup.
A handoff left, McCaffrey. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down. They'll give it up to McCaffrey. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. 9 yards the pickup there, and it's a first down.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
Zone now. They'll look to throw. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10.
First carry for the former Florida Gator, Jordan Scarlett.
And again, he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. On
on third down, Shaw. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And he'll be tackled right on the 10, well short of the first down. Call it a 3-yard gain, and that's going to make it fourth down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
Here's Michael Badgley, ready for the field goal try.
A 27-yard attempt.
Badgley able to punch this one through. And the Panthers stake claim to a 3-0 lead. Every possession in the postseason magnified. And look, it's just the opening drive. They didn't get the touchdown they wanted, but at least they got on the board.
They got on the board. They've got their home crowd into it as well. And remember, in the playoffs, the game slows down a little bit. So every point is precious.
This is taken at the 3. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Here come the Seahawks and their offense now under veteran head coach Pete Carroll. They'll be led out by their 5'11 quarterback from Wisconsin by way of NC State, and that's Russell Wilson.
He's always been an incredible decision maker on the field. Takes care of the ball really well, puts his team in the right positions, makes sure the play calls are accurate. Also was a minor league baseball player. Didn't hit very well there. I think he made a great career choice picking football.
An opening there on that first down run as he gets this forward for about 8 or 9. That looks to be 8 officially, so 2nd and 2. On 2nd down now, it's Carson, and he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, 1st down. That's a jet sweep into the hands of Metcalf. And that one covered beautifully. Their defenders stayed home, and they'll stop him behind the line. Call it a loss of 2 on the play. And it'll be 2nd and 12.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time because, let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
On 2nd down, it's Carson. After getting stuffed on 1st down, not much better there. 2-yard gain. And we take a look at the offense for the Seahawks.
And this is a unit that has to feel good about itself. Got the win last week in the wild card round, and oftentimes we say you want to get the open week and get some rest. But many times we see the upsets happen with a team that won the week before and has momentum on its side.
That's complete into the hands of Carson. Now Carson fumbles the football, and it's picked up by the Panthers.
Thank goodness for heaters up here. And thank goodness I don't have to carry the football in this game. It's January. It's cold out there. Trying to clutch the football and absorb the hits. Not easily done.
Yeah, we saw a product of the elements right there. The Panthers offense here, they get ready to head back on the field. They've got a 3-0 lead and the football as they start 1st and 10. This is McCaffrey, and he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. Adrian Claiborne, the one who makes the stop. This is McCaffrey on the give, and that didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped in the backfield. It's a loss of 4. Now 3rd down.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is at well over 300 pounds. He's a big man.
looking to throw. Shaw, and they've got the hookup. This is Olsen. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, and it's good for a first down as well.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
Throw. Shaw. This is caught. For a Panthers touchdown. From 8 yards out. And the Panthers, they widen their lead.
And that's exactly what you're supposed to do with good field position. You make the other side pay when you don't have far to go for the score.
Michael Badgley on for the extra point. Footing likely going to be an issue all night here on a rainy night, but this one is good. Just a four-play drive that time, and Carolina scores to cap it off. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This one taken from the 7. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line.
Let's go.
The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Yeah, they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. A throw left side to start the drive is complete. The completion good for 3, and it's second down. And the starting crew defensively for Carolina.
Kaywon Short came out of Purdue as one of the top-rated defensive tackle prospects. Now he's one of the top-rated NFL players.
That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. Wilson. Oh, he took that in one-handed. What a grab.
We got this.
His first reception of the divisional round matchup, but it's good for a first down as well.
Okay, it's time for me to break out my thesaurus for that one. And I don't have anything. That was amazing. One-handed in this weather. I mean, you know the ball's got to be slick. But to be able to catch it and come down with it. What do they call that? The process of the catch? He completed it all the way through.
They'll run on first down. Carson, and he'll get across midfield and into Carolina territory. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a 2nd and 1. Wilson going to fake the give and keep it himself. It's caught. Lockett. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. And on 3rd down, a nickel formation here defensively. From the gun, it's Wilson. Here's Carson with a catch out of the backfield. And he's going to have a 1st down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
On 1st down, it's Carson. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's 2nd down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage.
Right there. 280. 54 miles.
On second down now, it's Carson, and he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. The second down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of one there. On third down, Wilson.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
So on is Jason Myers. He's hit from as long as 58 in his career. And this will be spotted on the other side of the field. It's a 61-yard attempt. And this is off target to the left. Didn't get there anyway. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. That would have been from way downtown. Pretty big roll of the dice, and he comes up a bit short.
Yeah, you knew when you saw the holder setting up on the other side of the 50 that this was going to be a long shot. But to me, there's really no loss here because you've shown confidence in him. Kicking it from a long distance, that'll pay dividends. And the miss, you can shake that one off. It wasn't likely to make it in the first place.
So they tried the 59-yarder and missed it. And now this offense starts just 1 yard shy of midfield. Now a handoff here to his running back. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. Looking to throw on second down. Shaw. And he's got the hook up to Moore. And he's taken down inside the 30. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Operating from the gun. Shaw. He finds his man, the tight end Olsen. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Greg Olsen, 29 yards. And the Panthers, they widen their lead. Badgley on for the extra point. He's got it, and it's 17-0. So they only needed 3 plays on that drive. And the end result, a Panthers touchdown. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This is taken at the 3. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line.
Let's go.
The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And the last go-around for them, they tried that really, really long field goal, couldn't connect.
And in retrospect, I think a lot of people would say, well, why would you try one that long? You hurt yourself in field position. The ball comes out, you know, there. That only helps the other team. But I look at it as maybe it was a double shot of confidence. Confident the kicker could make it. And even if he missed, confident in their defense that they could hold him.
10 yards and a Seattle first down. Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going, and they're controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards. I also like what the runner's giving us, too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off.
Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and 8. From the 40 now on second down, Wilson. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. They follow up the gain of 2 with a gain of 1 that time. Wilson to throw on third down. Open man is Metcalf. He's got it. Two catches now in this divisional round matchup. That one, a first down.
But we always hear about the connections some quarterbacks have with certain receivers. I think this guy has a connection with just about everyone. Didn't mind throwing it in there against double coverage to him.
Shows some confidence, supreme confidence.
Big time confidence that he would make the play for him, and he did.
They'll run on first down. Carson takes this to the 45. Broken tackle. Bought him a little extra space. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. Here's Carson, and able to push forward for right around 3 yards down to the 42. So third and two, this quite possibly four down territory, though, if they're stopped. Now it's Carson, and he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. An effective 7 yard third down conversion. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. 17-0, our score after one. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Now they'll throw it with Wilson. That's into the hands of his tight end, Will Disley. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. It's a gain of 12, first down Seahawks. On first down, it's Carson. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive here, second and 11. Throwing is Wilson. Throw left side complete. That's Carson. No gain there, and it's going to bring up a third down. The Seahawks on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is third and 11. Out of the gun. Here's Wilson. He's got his man. It's Curse. And he's going to be taken down short of the first, right around the 15-yard line. They do get 9, but it leads to fourth down.
One of the money routes for any offense, the drag route. So tough to defend because the receiver can stop at any point and make himself available to the quarterback and get a completion. But I love the communication we saw there. All the defenders pointing out the receiver, where he was going, and then they're able to rally to the ball after the catch and stop him short of a first down.
Myers' kick is good. And they're on the board at least here. It's now 17-3. A dozen plays on that drive that ends with the field goal.
Let's go ahead and break out some of the old chestnuts here, right, partner? Keep the ball in front, rally to it, and make the tackle. Right? No big plays given up. No balls over your head. Bend, don't break.
Hold on. Chestnuts?
Huh? You like
Come
that
on.
One?
What does that mean, break out? That just because you break chestnuts?
I'm not sure about that, but I'm just going with why they said that. I have no idea.
And a good return. He's across the 35-yard line, right around the 36. Now we get a peek at the captain of this offense heading back out there. And he's been good. 2 first-half touchdown passes, no interceptions so far.
Does a lot for your confidence. Does a great deal for your team. Gives them a lead, and they're feeling really good about how they're playing. I think he expects to throw at least another one.
I was going to say, now he wants the first-half hat trick, doesn't he?
Oh, without a doubt. Go ahead and fling him on the field, folks. He wants that type of celebration.
It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4. Second and 4.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing.
And now the ball's out. Fumble near midfield. And the Seahawks have picked it up. And his guys will set up shop at midfield at the 50-yard line.
All these years we've been watching the game, I start to get the sense that whenever it rains out, those guys who have to touch the ball and carry it, they're extremely resentful about that weather.
Yeah, I'm just happy I'm not resentful that we have a roof over our heads. I know that much.
Yeah, maybe we won't fumble our play sheets here as we just saw the fumble happen on the field.
The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. And it's been very much a slow start for them. Three drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Yeah, if you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is one. And that's not going to get it done in a ball game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones, not having balls go through goalposts.
And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. First down, Seattle on a pickup of 13. They'll run on first down. Carson, and he'll snag about 5 yards down to the 32. Wilson, after the play fake to Carson. Pressure comes, and Wilson's going to go down. Gerald McCoy, he's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of 9.
Now, someone's been up to the task so far in this game. They are already up a couple of scores, Brandon, and guess what? I think they're just going to pin their ears back now and get upfield and get after the quarterback.
Been such an impressive first half to get that lead. Wilson of the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's third and long here. From the shotgun, Wilson. And this is caught by Curse. And he's going to be out of bounds down around the 35-yard line.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
So distance not the issue there. He had plenty of leg to get it there. It's that darn upright getting in the way.
Always gets in the way of a good time, doesn't it? Because he hit it square, too. Sometimes you can bank one in if you get it on the end of the football. No such luck there for him.
There's DJ Moore as he and the rest of the offense head back out there. He's doing what he's capable of, having a solid game. Not the most amazing game. He's not over 100 yards, but a good game so far.
And you just know that mentally, he feels like he's one catch away from turning it into a great game and starting on that road. And the defenders are well aware of that, too. They've got to figure out a way to not let that escalate. Keep him right in this zone here and call it a day, because otherwise, he can really decimate them.
Better believe they are well aware of his playmaking ability. You mentioned very early on the need to establish a running game for this young QB. They really haven't been able to do that, though, in the first half.
So that means what in halftime? Adjustments. Time, right? Figure out what they are. Figure out the things that they really want to accomplish and who to run behind. Which are your better blockers? Find them.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. The sack coming from Adrian Claiborne off the edge.
Well, maybe that can give him a little bit of a pick-me-up, a little bit of a jolt. One of the few things has gone right defensively.
Because other than that, it's really been a first half to forget. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Looking to throw. Shaw and Olsen over the middle. And he's going to be taken down right at the line. The completion there winds up a wash, and it'll bring up fourth down.
Pass complete, but no gain.
No yards.
Yeah.
So you file that as unsuccessful.
Yeah, you do, don't you? Except on the stats, throwing the ball.
Get a completion.
You get a catch.
Yeah.
But still, no yardage. Okay.
So on fourth down, kicking it away here, Michael Pilardi. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And did they keep it in? They did. They kept it in. It's down close to the goal line at the 1 yard line. Amazing. Perfectly placed. If that ball goes one extra yard, maybe not even an extra yard, the starting point is the 20.
So there is a reason that a lot of punters are also excellent golfers. They know distance control. You know what else they have? Same groove motion over and over. Once they have that down, it repeats under pressure.
Check, check. Watch it before. Man, that's trash. That's trash. Hey, switch here.
They'll start out on the ground with Carson. And he'll get him a little bit of breathing room across the 5 to the 6 yard line. The former LSU Tiger Dante Jackson on the stop. On second down, it's Carson. And he's going to be taken down shy of the 10, right around the 9 yard line. Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3 yard gain brings up a third down.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments. It doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
And he will have the first down as he's up to his 17-yard line. It goes as a gain of 8, and it moves the chains.
And that's the big fella's M.O. right there. Running through tackles, keeping the sticks moving forward. This defense, if you don't bring 11 guys to the ball to try and get him on the ground, he's going to keep making runs like that. I feel the press box shaking every time he touches the rock.
Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble.
Plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back, because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
On second down now, it's Carson, and running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a 3rd and 4. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Gerald McCoy, his 2nd sack of the night. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
On 4th down, ready to punt, Michael Dixon. Christian McCaffrey deep for Carolina. So possession goes over here on the punt. Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. And thus far, the weather has not slowed this offense down one bit. They've looked good so far in the first half.
They certainly have. And think back to our meeting with the head coach. And we asked him, because we saw the forecast for this game, didn't we? We said, hey, have you prepared for this? And he talked about the different drills that they've done in adverse conditions, the wet ball drills, things of that nature. He said, I don't think it's going to slow us down much. We tend to handle it pretty well, and he's been right.
A first down run, not going to get him a whole lot. Maybe a yard. Yeah, it looks like just 1 yard there. So that'll bring up 2nd and 9. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. He'll wind up getting 3 on the keeper there, but it leads to a 3rd down. The Panthers on 3rd down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. Back to throw. Shaw. The connection here with Nelson Aguilar. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, but it's good for a 1st down as well. This quarterback now nearly perfect. 9 of 10 in this first half. It's 1st and 10. McCaffrey on the counter. So he got 3 of 1 tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. Darren Lee there to get him down. A handoff, McCaffrey running right. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair.
That's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that. Got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
The Panthers on 3rd down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is 3rd and 11. Looking to throw. Shaw completes it to Aguilar. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as a tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks 33.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
This quarterback now, only one pass has hit the ground for him. 10 of 11 thus far. It's first and 10. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Second quarter action, 2 minutes to go on divisional round weekend. We remind you, as we've done all year, that coming up at halftime, we will visit with Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll let you know what's going on here on a very eventful divisional round weekend. And he's got McCaffrey open, complete. A gain of 4 on the play, and that'll lead here to a third down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
This will be the eighth play of the drive. It's 3rd and 7. From the gun, Shaw. And he'll dump this off to his running back, McCaffrey. He's the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. They're not going to get it. They try to move the chains with a surprise, but it's a turnover on downs. They pass up the 3, fake it. It doesn't work. And the Seahawks are going to take over the football. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And this not an easy situation. You're down early in the elements. You're on the road. How do you get the mojo back?
Well, one thing is to remember that as an offensive player, you have a much better idea of what you're trying to accomplish and where you're trying to go than the defender. So in this case, because you know it, you can make your cuts with a little more decisiveness. Maybe a second fake, some double moves, things of that nature to go
ahead. And he loses the football a second time. And it's picked up by the Panthers. And maybe that one caused by the weather, of course, the rain coming down. Charles, can you maybe, when you're carrying that football, grip it too tight in the rain?
I think that you can, and it's such a delicate balance, too, because when you grip it so tight, sometimes it'll slip out from your body. You squeeze it too hard, and it'll pop out on its own. I've actually had running backs talk to me about that, that when they've tried too hard, even in perfect conditions, the ball gets away from them. They've got to find that good balance, carrying it firmly, yet at the same time under control.
I can't believe they let you play. I can't believe they even let you play.
Following the fumble recovery, Shaw. And that's complete to McCaffrey. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up 2nd and 6. 2nd and 6. And he's got it. Got his man on the end route. Complete. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. This quarterback now pretty remarkable. 14 of 15 through the air. Only one incompletion. And another 1st and 10 here. Back to throw. Shaw gets this to his running back. It's Christian McCaffrey. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. It'll be a pickup of just 2, and it'll be a 2nd down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
So 2nd and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on 1st down. Here's 2nd and 8. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. Christian McCaffrey
there to make the grab. And the Panthers, they widen their lead.
Heard a coach talk about those late in the half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. Here's Badgley now to try to add the PAT. And the lead now to three touchdowns at 21 points. A drive there of just four plays. And Carolina scores to cap it off. Is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This will be taken in at the one. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line.
Let's go.
Chris Carson trotting back out there. He's been pretty effective so far, solid numbers yardage-wise, but the fumble last time, that's what he's thinking about. Has to be a little bit more secure.
Yeah, he does. Would you yell at him right here? Would you get on him?
No, I think you pick him up, don't you?
I agree with you totally. You pick him up in this situation because a lot of game left to be played, and he can be special with the ball in his hands. This in that situation, he wasn't, but you talk to him about the 4 points of pressure, high and tight to the body, and let him go back to it.
Well, still plenty of time in this game, so he'll have opportunities to secure that ball with those 4 points of pressure.
Okay, Brandon, this is the second of four games this weekend as we narrow the field down to the four teams who will meet in the league championship games next Sunday. We'll get back out to you guys in just a moment. But first, let's take a look ahead to tomorrow's other divisional round game in the NFC. And it looks like we've got a good one in store, as it's going to be the Tampa Bay Buccaneers taking on the Chicago Bears. Meanwhile, in our game, we're set up for a terrific second half. So to find out who will advance to the NFC title game, let's send it back out to Brandon Gott.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. A trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. Second half action back underway. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. So here they come, the road team now getting the football first to start this third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. That one definitely helps as they try to push the ball down the field here, trailing early in the third quarter.
And even though they're trailing, not abandoning the running game. People may call it an adjustment. I think it's just much more sticking to what works for you and continuing to have faith in it. And the running game is starting to pay off.
Now this one over the middle into the hands of his tight end, complete. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. Now Wilson. This one into the hands of Metcalf. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. 7 yards there and a first down. On first down, Carson. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. They keep it on the ground. This time it's Penny. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. 1st and 10. Now Rashad Penny. And he'll get four here down to the 35-yard line. The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. They'll toss it out to Carson. He'll be taken down well behind the line, and I think he might have just given those 4 yards right back. That second down play nets a minus four.
I know the speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Now Wilson from the gun, he'll throw. Strong coverage by Carolina, and on we go to fourth down.
I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback, but when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps to have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
And I don't think this has the carry. It does not. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. And it's hard to hold a kick from this distance against him, but that is now three misses for him in the game so far.
Three! And you wonder where his head's at right now. Kickers are a funny breed, but I have a feeling he'd love to see a 29-yarder next time to get him back in the groove.
The Panthers offense now, they head back on the field for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
And how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. Give him 15 there, and the Panthers have a first down.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Operating from the gun, Shaw, and this one's incomplete. Greg Olsen was the intended target, but it'll be second down. So line of scrimmage, still the 39 on second and 10. Here's Shaw, and it's a fumble, and the Seahawks have picked it up. And he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But, hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big-time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. And they had compiled a pretty long drive last time. Unfortunately, though, it ended with no points after the missed field goal.
And that can hurt the psyche of a team because as they drove downfield, you know you're never supposed to count points in your mind until they go up on the board. But let's face it, we've been there. We've seen teams before. They were counting on those points. They didn't get them. Can they come back now, start over again, and grind it out?
And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards. They'll find Metcalf. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. They run it with Carson. And he's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
So right after the defense gets you the ball on a takeaway and a fumble recovery of their own, you've got to reward them, don't you? You've got to stay out on the field, give them a chance to rest, and how about doing it the way they did it, running the football and picking it up on third down.
Yeah, would not have wanted to go three and out. They avoid that right there.
Yeah, they avoided the glares as they went back to the bench, didn't they?
Mike 54. Watch the run, watch the run.
Throwing now, Wilson on first down. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on to the contact. Brings up second down. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Wilson, nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
So one quick, easy analysis about why they've struggled so far. They keep putting themselves in third and long situations. They just took another sack right there.
Now the offensive film session tomorrow may be a little longer than it normally is.
Not a lot of positive grades will be handed out thus far.
Wilson of the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's third and long here. From the gun, it's Wilson. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Dante Jackson picks it, and the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line.
So it's third and long, and you know this is going to be a pass. So defensively, they bring in an extra defensive back and just blanket the field. And this is an ill-advised throw right here as it winds up being picked off easily.
Christian McCaffrey and the Panthers about set to go on offense. And after a sluggish start, he's really bounced back. The numbers bear that out.
And you're a baseball guy, partner. How many at-bats over the course of a baseball season?
Oh, boy, four in a game.
Four
times 162.
350 or so, right? Sometimes it takes a while for a guy to get going. That's my point. It's not the first few carries. You don't worry about that. As they go along, get that guy lathered up, get those blocking assignments down. Those two-yard gains turn into bigger gains as the game moves along.
That throw good for four. It's second down.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
Looking to throw. Shaw. And they've got the hookup. This is Olsen. Seven catches for him now, and this last one, a first down.
As an unbiased observer, I think it would have been interesting to see what they would have done if they hadn't gotten the first down there. But since they did, I guess the point is moot.
And they're right there in that middle ground, field goal range, punt, go for it. But as you said, they picked it up. He gets this down about the 21 or 22. The dump off good for eight there on first down. To throw on second down, Shaw. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
And he is out of bounds, getting it down to the 10. A good pickup of six there on first down. Looking to throw on second down. Shaw. And that will be caught by 10 yards on the touchdown pass. And the Panthers, they widen their lead. And right now, Charles, I think you'd have to say their class starting to show through.
Yeah, they were disappointed not to get the number one seed in the playoffs, but the reality is these guys can play anywhere. It doesn't matter for them.
And if they can indeed hold on to this lead, that's going to set up one heck of a championship game next Sunday.
Let's come back and watch it, shall we?
Something tells me you and I are going to be there. A good hold in these wet conditions. The point after is up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 28. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told. And the end result, a Panthers touchdown. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. They've got to dig down deep. I mean, they need something right now, really anything to cling on to. This offense has struggled.
partner, join me in a walk to their locker room at the half, okay? Because I think what we would have seen is an offensive coordinator and his assistant coaches getting together with all their positions, then coming together as a group, going over adjustments, and then the head coach coming in and just screaming, wake up. Yeah. Let's get moving, guys.
I'm kind of glad we weren't in there at halftime, actually.
I mean, you think you might have turned it on us, too?
Yeah, but right now, whatever was said hasn't been working. Looking to throw again on second down. Wilson, they'll run the screen with Carson. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. Call that a loss of 5 yards on the play. And that'll make it third down.
Time to give a little credit here. That was an excellent read by the guys on the defensive side of the ball.
Oh, you're crediting your defense.
Gotta credit them on that one because they tried to fool them, right? Tried to trick them. Ran a screen, and they went to and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
Well, that last completion, certainly not what they were hoping for, as now they'll try to convert on third. That's complete into the hands of Carson. And I think the ball's out.
I don't know about you, but I could hear and feel the sigh of relief all the way up here in our booth.
That was palpable. The sideline, the friend there.
No doubt about it. Ball goes over the sideline, able to retain possession, no turnover. I know his coaches are screaming, just hang on to the ball, man.
Now here's Michael Dixon as he'll kick it away for the second time. That's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. Carolina getting set to take the field. And last time out, another touchdown. I think there may be some empty seats around here by the time the fourth quarter comes around.
Yeah, I have to agree with you because this one's just about decided. But you know who benefits from all those empty seats? You and me, trying to get to the airport. That's the road to be fairly clear
that is
by the
one
time
positive.
We have to leave the booth.
It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and four.
A 6-yard pickup brings up second and four.
To throw on second down, Shaw. He finds his man, the tight end Olsen. 7 yards there and a first down.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
This quarterback now perfect since the second half started. 7 of 7. It's first and 10. From the shotgun to McCaffrey. And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here. In on the stop, Bradley McDougal. This is Scarlett on the carry. Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40. From the gun on third down, Shaw. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. It was Trey Flowers that time who got a hand in and broke it up.
Certainly looked like they were getting ready to convert there on third down, but what an effort to get his hand on that one, knock it away, and brings up a fourth down decision.
Here's Michael Pilardi now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough because we always talk about it being a team game, and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else.
10 yards on the pickup. It's second and
On second and very short, Wilson. And he's got his man on the out route. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down. They go play action now. Wilson. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete. Second and 10 from the 33-yard line. Draw play. This is Carson. And he'll work this one up to about the 38.